Hi, I am David Kaplan and we are here for our second show. So let's start the show. Right now. What I want to talk about is. Niklas Hjalmarsson. Is he going to cut it? Or should the Hawks be looking for a trade partner? Hockey Life 07. What do you think? People wanting this guy moved as soon as possible. And assuming so, doesn't make much sense to me, and I'll tell you why. He is 24 years old. He is a very young defenseman, so of course he's going to make some mistakes. This is not the best we will see of him. Defensemen get better with age. Also, Stan Bowman classified Hammer as a core player and gave up 2 draft picks plus Niemi and Ladd for him. If Hammer improves over time as most D-men have, will 3.5 million seem so bad? Or will it be a bargain? Big T. Your take?
I think the problem here is. The Hawks have younger kids that can do the same thing but cheaper. You have to realize this. He signed an RFA offer sheet in the middle of Stan's struggles. He held a gun to Stan's head and we lost Ladd because of it. I think we need to look at the whole picture, rather than the jersey you bought. With Hammer gone this summer, it allows the Hawks to improve their team. And if the Hawks happen to miss the playoffs, don't even dream of having a $3.5 million underachiever at the expense of a better team.
By losing a 24-year-old defenseman with huge upside, you think that will allow the Hawks to improve as a team?
Okay, your talk about upside. Now back it up. What has he done to ensure this upside? He blocks shots. So does Sopel. For a lot cheaper. How many career goals does Hanna have? I bet they fit all on one hand. Keith, Chara. These guys have more goals than Hammer has points. So again, what upside? He is what he is. An overpaid shot blocker. The Hawks can't afford this. Plain and simple. This is nothing personal. More or less just the reality of a salary cap.
Man, you're totally missing my point. I am saying he may not be worth 3.5 mil now, but it's a 4-year deal. So neither you or I could declare ourselves right until he has played out his contract. If you got offered $3.5 million from a contending hockey team, would you not take it? He was only a Hawk for one full year prior to that. Players gotta make a living too.
I'll make this abundantly clear. Hammer is no scapegoat. He's just overpaid. And I think that many believe that the team would be better off spending that money elsewhere. Including me. He is what he is. A shot blocker. He's prone to injuries, and I'm aware that he hasn't been bit yet. But in due time. 3.5 million for a guy who doesn't change the game is a little rough.
Skilly is already gone. Kopetsky makes 1.2 million, so he should be gone. Stalberg gone. Don't need Sopel. Right there, you got an extra 2 plus million. Bring more in. Letty, beach up, have a non-hangover, refresh year. Resign for a leak somehow. As bad as it seems, the Hawks are not as far off as you think from being a top 4 seed. For me, I do not see them having a fringe-type season next year.
What the hell are you talking about? Straight? Skilly gone? Yeah, so. Frolik makes double his salary. I never said anything about them being a fringe team. I'm just saying that the status quo isn't good enough. And to be in the same tight cap situation next year with the same team is depressing. That's it. No more to the story. No need to try and make things up. With your assessment, where's the grit that we need to get? How do you go about that? Even if Stalberg is gone, someone has to replace him. Do we really want a team with 4 or 5 more rookies next year?
Well, that's it, folks. Hope you return next week for some more great topics.